Gregory of the United States, who I thought Dick Button turned in a very poised performance last night, considering the dual problem of his back and the fall that she suffered in the compulsories on Sunday.
Well, I think they're super competitors. They've really pulled themselves together. They've been under an enormous amount of pressure here. The first time, really today, is the first time that he has been skating without a brace. And that's a great, you know, thing, a great weight on your mind.
Susie, the pride of Bridgeville, Pennsylvania, Scott Gregory from Skaneateles, New York, a couple of small-town Americans. Let's have a look at the couple I was talking with Torval and Dean about, Dick. Here are the Duchesnays, and they're unorthodox, not only in their approach to this event, but in their costumes, for sure.
Well, these costumes represent the theme of their program, which is called a war dance, or savage rite. And they play, in a sense, two savages who have very animalistic, basic emotions. It's really quite an extraordinary dance at the European Championship. It created a great controversy and was very exotic and extremely effective.
But did not get that great a reception from the judges,
well,
is that right?
Yes, they won the bronze medal there.
Okay.
But I assure you, it was a big controversy.
Yeah.
The real question is whether you're going to go into the more ballroom style of dancing or whether you're going to be more creative and original in the style that Torval and Dean were. If you're going to do that, you've got to be technically very good.
Well, Christopher Dean said to me that he's, for one, which they would allow more leeway, more freedom to move into new areas.
Remember, these free dances, they don't allow the triple throw axles and the flying moves that you see in pair skating. That's the one rule about ice dancing that's clear. It shall not look like pair skating, and this dance, I assure you, does not.
They represent France, but these are Canadians, really. They're both from the province of Quebec, and that's a Canadian reception.
And one of the things that helps them is they both have a fiery temperament, and that suits this program.
Thank you.
that saddle dome has a strong roof. Listen to this.
Very much a standing ovation, and in my book, it certainly does deserve it. Original, unique, exotic, so down into the ice, so animalistic, so very much Christopher Dean.
Isabelle and Paul Duchesnay, representing France, but residents of the province of Quebec and Canada.
Basically, they kind of moved to France to skate there because they felt they would not progress rapidly in the French-Canadian ice dancing, or in the Canadian ice dancing scene.
Remarkable stuff.
Oh, really beautiful. Notice particularly how down they are through the whole thing, the backs down into the ice. That is extraordinarily difficult to sustain that position for the 4 minutes of this dance.
They are special. Age 24, she is, he's 26.
Well, now look at this. Here's the first set of marks.
Here's the big question. Yeah, what do the judges think?
They start with a 5-2 from the Canadian judge. The rest all 5-4s to 5-1, 5-7.
Do you see any significance in the Canadian judge giving them the lowest mark?
I don't really know the answer to that, Jim. The rest of the marks are pretty consistent.
Yeah.
I don't know what she has in mind, and I can't really answer that question until I see what the other marks come.
Okay.
But look at these. Oh, my goodness.
5-1 to 5-8, 5-0. They're all over the place.
That is something.
David, their marks are all over the place. What about that?
With a program that's so totally different, what do you think the impact will have on the sport of ice dancing?
I think we'll have to wait and see. I hope it keeps progressing the way Chortle and Dean did.
An innovative and daring program. Thank you.
Well, that puts them in lead among those who have skated, but they were eighth coming into this final, and of course all of the leaders are yet to come.